Hello everyone, welcome to Unlock Maths. Today we have to find nth derivative of e raised to ax into cos of bx plus c. So let's write here y is equals to e raised to ax into cos of bx plus c, where this a, b and c, these are the constants, and here we have to find its nth derivative. That means first here we have to find y1, then y2, y3 up to yn, right? Yes. So let's differentiate this y with respect to x. Differentiating y, we get first derivative y1, and here we have two different functions, so we have to apply product rule of differentiation. So here we have first function into derivative of second, cos derivative, this is minus sine of bx plus c into b, right? And second function, this is as it is into derivative of first, this is e raised to ax into a, right? So we got this first derivative. Now we can check that here we have e raised to ax, this is common, so take this is outside, and in bracket remaining here we have, now we can shift this minus to this side, so we have here this is cos of bx plus c into a minus of sine bx plus c into b, right? Yes. So we got this is first derivative y1. Now when we differentiate this y1 to get y2, we get bigger term than this one, since here all these functions have non-vanishing derivatives, right? So same for y3, y4 up to yn. So for the sake of convenience, what we have to do, we have to convert this bracket, this expression into smaller one by using some substitution. So we have to do here substitution. A is equals to r cos theta and this b is equals to r sine theta. So by using this substitution, we have, now here we have r common, so we can take this is outside this bracket. So here we have r into e raised to ax and remaining expression as it is. Now take a look on this expression. Yes, this looks like cos of a plus b. Yes, we have this is cos of a into cos of b minus of sine of a into sine of b. Here we can check that this expression is similar to this one, where this value of a, this is here, and b is theta, right? So here we have this is cos of bx plus c plus theta, right? So we have convert this bigger expression into smaller one and we got this first derivative. So we have to note down that here in given y we have cos, so it's good to convert this cos into this cos function so that we can find its further derivative easily. For this conversion we have used this substitution, and now here we have to find what is the value of r and theta. So let's proceed for finding values of r and theta. Thus here we have find value of r and value of theta. R is equals to, this is root of a square plus b square, and theta is equals to tan inverse b by a, right? So we have find first derivative y1, this is given by r into e raised to ax into cos of bx plus c plus theta, where this r and theta is given by these values. Now from this y1, we have to find second derivative. Differentiating y1, we get y2, and this is here now. At this time, this r is constant, so this is as it is, and we have to apply product rule on this one, right? So first function into derivative of second minus of sine bx plus c plus theta. This derivative is with respect to x, so here b plus second function cos of bx plus c plus theta into derivative of first. This is e raised to ax into a, right? Yes. So now, at this time, this is e raised to ax, this is common. So take this is outside. So here we have e raised to ax, and shifting this minus to this side. So here we have cos of bx plus c plus theta into a minus sine of bx plus c plus theta into b, right? Yes. Now again we have to use the substitution to convert this bigger term into smaller one. So substitution is a is equals to r cos theta and b is equals to r sine theta. So by using this substitution here, we have y2 is equals to r into e raised to ax. We have used this value of a and b in this bracket. So here we got this term. Now again we can check that here we have r common. So we can take this is outside this bracket. So here we have this r and this r. This is r square into e raised to ax. And remaining expression, this is as it is. Now again, take a look on this expression. This is cos of a into cos of b minus sine of a into sine of b. So this is the expansion of cos of a plus b, right? So by using this, here we have y2 is equals to r square into e raised to ax. This is, by considering this is as a a and this is as a theta as a b. So here we have cos of bx plus c plus theta, right? So here we have y2 is equals to r square into e raised to ax into cos of bx plus c plus twice theta, right? So we got this is second derivative. Now we can check that here for y2 here we have twice theta, and for y1 we got here theta, right? So by comparing this y1 and y2, we can write y3. So similarly here we have y3, right? Again, yes, in y1 here we have r, and in y2 here we have r square. So for y3 here we will have r cube e raised to ax into cos of bx plus c plus thrice theta, right? So this is we have write down y3, and in general here we can write y4, y5 up to yn. So same here we can write y4. What is y4? This is r raised to 4 e raised to ax into cos of bx plus c plus 4 theta. This is the fourth derivative, right? So in the same manner we can write here nth derivative. So differentiating y n times we get yn. So what will be yn here? This is r raised to n into e raised to ax into cos of bx plus c plus n theta, right? where we know that what is the value of r and what is theta. R is here root of a square plus b square, and theta is equals to tan inverse b by a, right? So we got nth derivative. So in this way we got nth derivative of e raised to ax into cos of bx plus c, and this is given by r raised to n e raised to ax into cos of bx plus c plus n theta, where we have find r and theta, and this is given by. So yes, in this way we have to proceed for finding nth derivative. So that's it for now. See you in the next video. Thank you. Keep watching.